Hello student, now today in this session of class 12 business studies, we will be going to discuss some of the methods of training. We have already gone through this concept that what is training and what is the importance of training in the organization for employees as well as for organization. Now, we want to improve the skills of the non-managerial person. At the same time, we want to develop the managerial level person also. So, there are different methods of providing the training. So, mostly two methods are being used for providing the training. Those are being categorized as on the job training and off the job training. Okay, on job training and off job training. The work or the training which is being given to you while working, that is known as on job training. And if you are being sent to some other place where you are getting that training in some other institutions, that is known as off the job training. So today we will be discussing some of the trainings in these two categories. So the first training, that is induction training. Induction training, basically it is given to the new employees. The employees who are being appointed or the fresh appointments of the candidates is being taking place. And after their appointment, this training is provided to those employees so that they can come to know about the nature of the organization. Okay? They can come to know about the key departments in the organization, key work areas in the organization, key positions in the organization, their responsibilities or their roles in the organization. So for this, the induction training is being organized. And in induction training, what are we supposed to learn? Introduction related with the business and its department. Okay, organization ka introduction aur jitne bhi departments hai un sab ki knowledge. Then layout of the building, that is the structure of the organization. So you should know about the complete layout of the building. Terms and the conditions of the employment. Aapki employment ki kya terms and conditions hai, that will be discussed with you. Then important policies of the organization. What are the important policies of the organization which you should be aware of. Then the values and the aims of the organization behind this business. So all these things should be known to each and every employee. So we are giving the induction training to the newly recruited employees so that they can feel themselves acquainted with the organization and they should be aware of the various terms and conditions of their employment and the policies of the organization, why this organization is working. So after taking the knowledge of the organization completely, then you can go and work in the organization. Then comes vestibule training. In vestibule training, this type of training is being provided to the new employees when the employees are being appointed in a group. Okay? So when the employees are being appointed in the group, this type of training is taking place, and in this training the employees are being sent for the training purpose outside the organization. This is a concept of off the job training. So outside the organization, in any other institutes, you will be sending your employees for taking the training. under the guidance of the specified instructor or the specialist instructor who will provide you this type of training. And this type of training is basically taking place where we are making the use of the machineries. So if you have appointed a group of person who are making the use of the various machineries or the tools and the equipments of the organization, then they should know that how they have to make the use of these machineries and the tools and the equipments. And for this they are being provided the training that is known as vestibule training. In the vestibule training, the employees are being sent outside the organization to take the training from the specialist person, and when they are going under the guidance of the specialist person, the training is being given to them to make the use of the various types of machinery, tools and equipments which are of the similar nature on which they have to perform their routine work. So after getting certified from the trainer, then the employees can go and start working in the organization. So there are some other methods of off-job training also, like case studies, films or any type of seminar or the program under which the specialist person can come and give their instructions or guidance to the employees. Now we move to the apprenticeship training. In the case of apprenticeship training, this is the training related with on-job method of training. Under a master trainer, the employees are getting the training, and this training period may exist for a long term period, maybe up to 6 or 7 years. Okay, so in this case you are constantly working under the master trainer, and you are doing your work also, as well as you are being getting the training also. So all types of technical work in which you are being involved are being done in this training, like the classroom lectures are also organized, and then you are asked to perform that work on the various types of equipments or the tools which are being made available to you and on which you have to work. For an example, welder, electrician or any other craftsman, artist, you have to work directly on these things. So this is known as apprenticeship training. Now we come to the last training, that is known as the internship training. In the internship training, what happens? There is a collaboration of the institutes. After taking your theoretical knowledge from a particular institute, now you are going for certain practical knowledge, because there are some type of work or job in which you have to take the practical knowledge before you started practicing this type of things in your routine work. So whatever theoretical knowledge you have gained in a particular institute or a college, now those institute or college are sending you to some other institute and college and perform the practical work. Let's say for the doctorate, if you want to become a doctor, so you are getting the theoretical knowledge in one of the college, and then you are being sent to some of the hospitals or the nursing home in which you have to take the internship training, and in that training you have to work there. So whatever theoretical knowledge you have gained, now you have to do the implementation of those theoretical knowledge in the reality. Okay, let's say for chartered accountant, whatever knowledge you have taken from the educational institute, now you will be asked to work under a professional person or a chartered accountant, and then you have to show your skills, that whatever you have acquired in the educational institute, now you have to make the use of those education or knowledge in the reality. So this is known as the internship training. Okay, so these were few trainings which we have discussed in this session related with the methods of training. Hope you have understood this type of training. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे।